No, she's gone, so why don't you come and sit down? We can talk.
We are talking.
Yeah, but you're not listening. Nico, losing you destroyed me. You're my little girl, and no matter what you did, I still loved you.
You loved the idea of me. Sophie. The perfect baby you gave birth to, not the freak I turned into.
That's not true.
Today's my birthday. Did you know that? My birthday. Not Sophie's. The day my foster parents kicked me out. The day I learned to look after myself. The day I became Nico. See, you don't know me at all.
Okay, but you never told me that.
You never asked. They thought they couldn't have kids. That's why they took me in. And then a miracle baby came along. And they didn't want me anymore. Said I couldn't be trusted around their precious daughter. Can you believe that?
Oh, no.
Do you think I'd hurt him?
No. I don't know.
He's a baby. My brother. Even I'm not that messed up.
Okay, I'm sorry, I'm not thinking straight. I have imagined seeing you again so many times. Never like this. I just can't believe you're really here. My baby. Where have you been? Do you have a home? Do you have somewhere safe to sleep?
Don't pretend you care.
I'm not. When I first saw you again, I was in shock. I still am. But I am so happy that you're still alive. And I know that you're hurt. And I know that you feel like I betrayed you. But please, Nico, don't punish me by disappearing out of my life again. I just couldn't take it.
So you think I can just stick around here and play happy families? When people find out I'm alive, I'll be wanted for murder.
Well, then we'll run away. You, me, Sebastian, I don't have anything to stay here for. You two are my whole world. We can start again somewhere new and be a real family. Please, Nico. Let me prove how much I love you. Let me be your mum again.